Hey, welcome to Football 101. It's Dave Wyman, and today we're going to look at a play from the Seahawks 33-27 loss against the Tennessee Titans. And they gave up almost 200 yards on the ground rushing. And this particular play is in the third quarter with about 1:49 left. DeMarco Murray, 75-yard touchdown run. First of all, let's check out some defensive stats. And down below the video here, you'll see posted run defense stats over the last 4 or 5 years. And the one that stood out to me the most is the average yards per carry. Last year in 2016, 3.4 yards. They were number one in the league. This year, 5.3. And they're number 32. They're dead last. So they got to fix some things. And I think there's some things that need to be cleaned up. But, you know, when you get into the running game, there's always two or three different things that we'll go through here that cause a play to get out the gate. Number one, I would say they got caught in a bad call because, and I'll just show you this first and just get it out of the way. It didn't end up actually totally messing up the defense, but they had a slant here by these two defensive tackles, and they're just crashing down here, and so it really just sort of seals off the entire left part of the defense. But even with that, they still get a 3-on-3 situation over here that I'll show you later. But first of all, they got caught in kind of a bad call, and I don't know if they would have maybe checked out of that. So, but let's look at first what Tennessee is doing on their side of the ball. They have kind of an unusual formation where they put an extra tackle in, and he's not a tight end, he doesn't have an eligible number, so this tackle right here, he has to report as eligible. But that's one thing, when you see an extra tackle in, alarm bell should go off that they're probably going to try to run to that heavy side. So, but he didn't start there, and this is what was pretty clever by Tennessee. He started over here, he went in motion, then he came up here and was on the line of scrimmage, and so they're all set here, and they actually looked okay because Jeremy Lane was lined up out here. Cam was up here on the line, and KJ Wright was all the way over here. And so they look like they're in pretty good situation to handle the run if it came this way. Well, then the guy goes in motion over here. So now he's over on the other side. And what these guys did is something called bump. They bumped over, and I think I've talked about it before. They just sort of align their, or change their alignment, so they go to a different spot. So instead of being lined up in these spots right here, they end up over here, and they kind of hurt themselves by alignment because they were so far over here, and they just gave themselves bad angles. So here's what happened. The tackle who's playing tight end, he just entirely washes down this side I mentioned earlier, and then this tackle folds around to block Cam, and that's okay. I mean, he can typically defeat that block. And then here comes the fullback. He comes running up here to block the corner, and he is supposed to have force. Now, we've talked about force before. What that is turning every running play back inside. And the reason why is because it's about 24 yards from the hash marks where the ball is always spotted to the sideline. So you really got to protect that part. And I mentioned earlier, Jeremy Lane was out here, and if he hadn't bumped so far, I think he'd have been able to take this on and actually get force and turn it back to KJ. Because the problem is, Cam comes across, he gets blocked, and that's going to happen. KJ is running as fast as he can, but he just never gets there. And the reason why is because Jeremy Lane, he comes up a little bit, but then he flattens out like this. So by this time, this blocker turns on him, and he finally does turn it back in, but it's right next to the sidelines. So by that time, it's basically a foot race between DeMarco Murray and KJ Wright, who's coming from all the way from the inside. And if he'd have been over here before the bump, before he adjusted his alignment, I think he would have got there. But KJ was just in a foot race with DeMarco Murray, and he won. And it got down the field, and there was all kinds of missed tackles and things like that. But, you know, and I've said, look, I think these things are easy to fix. You usually go through and look at what's happening. Sometimes it's you're in a bad call. Sometimes it's beaten by alignment. You don't bump as far next time. Maybe that's their adjustment. And then, it's tackling. as well. So I look for the Seahawks. I just don't see how, with not many personnel changes, and actually I think they got better on defense, that they can go from number one to number 32. I don't know if they're going to get back up to number one this year, but I expect things to correct as the season goes on.